prophet Jeremiah. This word of the Lord came to me. Go, cry out this message for Jerusalem to hear. I remember the devotion of your youth, how you loved me as a bride, following me in the desert, in a land unsown. Sacred to the Lord was Israel, the first fruits of his harvest. Should any presume to partake of them, evil would befall them, says the Lord. When I brought you into the garden to eat its goodly fruits, you entered and defiled my land. You made my heritage loathsome. The priests asked not, where is the Lord? Those who dealt with the law knew me not. The shepherds rebelled against me. The prophets prophesied by Baal and went after useless idols. Be amazed at this, O heavens, and shudder with sheer horror, says the Lord. Two evils have my people done. They have forsaken me, the source of living waters. They have dug themselves cisterns, broken cisterns that hold no water. The word of the Lord. With you is the fountain of life, O Lord. With you is the fountain of life. O Lord, your mercy reaches to heaven, your faithfulness to the clouds. Your justice is like the mountains of God, your judgments like the mighty deep. With you is the fountain of life, O Lord. How precious is your mercy, O God. The children of men take refuge in the shadow of your wings. They have their fill of the prime gifts of your house. From your delightful stream, you give them to drink. With you is the fountain of life, O Lord. For with you is the fountain of life, and in your light we see light. Keep up your mercy toward your friends, your just defense of the upright of heart. With you is the fountain of life.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The disciples approached Jesus and said, "Why do you speak to the crowds in parables?" He said to them in reply, "Because knowledge of the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven has been granted to you, but to them it has not been granted. To anyone who has, more will be given, and he will grow rich. From anyone who has not, even what he has will be taken away. This is why I speak to them in parables, because they look but not see, and hear but not listen or understand. Isaiah's prophecy is fulfilled in them, which says, 'You shall indeed hear, but not understand. You shall indeed look, but never see. Cross in the heart of his people, they will hardly hear with their ears. They have closed their eyes, lest they see with their eyes and hear with their ears, and understand with their hearts, and be converted, and I heal them. But blessed are your eyes, because they see, and your ears because they hear. Amen, I said to you, many prophets and righteous people long to see what you see, but they did not see, and to hear what you hear, but they did not hear. The Gospel. A short reflection for us this morning. We take this from the Gospel of today. Jesus is speaking to the crowd, and answering their question, why do you speak in parables? I thought it was a legitimate question. Because they felt the parables were not clear to them. And yet Jesus says, I do speak in parables. Why? Because not everybody will understand what they are saying. And you will say, then if you think they don't understand, why don't you speak in a plain language? But look, here what Jesus is trying to say is whatever he says should be understood to those who are willing to hear and who are willing to listen. The problem was not because Jesus spoke in parables. The problem was they were not willing to listen, and they were not willing to hear what he said. And then at the last part of the Gospel he says, blessed are you who hear what you hear, and you see what you see. And I think, dear brothers and sisters, we are among those who are blessed to be able to hear the word of God. God is speaking to us. How lucky are we? And not only that, to be able to see him. And you will tell me, but I've never seen him. Yes, you have seen him. You have touched him. Jesus in the Eucharist. Present. We have seen him. We have touched him. He says, lucky are you. And so, with this reading and what we are celebrating today, St. Bridget of Sweden, a wonderful mother. She was married, had 8 children, raised them so nicely, and when her husband died, she continued to devote her life in the service of prayer and God's people. We are told she even founded a religious community, and she joined the Third Order of the Franciscans. And yet, with all that, she contemplated the Passion of Christ. In one of her beautiful prayers, Bridget says, when we look at the Christ and the cross of Christ, we feel relieved. We find hope. For it is by that cross he brought life into the world. And I'm thinking, he as the mother of 8 children had time for God and dedicated her service and prayer not only for her children, but for the people of God, including so many writings. What a lesson for us today, dear friends. We who are living in this busy world, so much to do and probably not enough time. Well, Jesus says, spare some moment and listen when I speak. Open your ears and hear when I speak. Open your eyes and see me. Just like St. Bridget, though she was busy as a mother of 8 children, yet she had a time for God. She was able to listen and ponder, particularly the mystery of the Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ.
receive from Christ, continue to conform us ever closer to his side. Let us pray to the Lord. For those in positions of authority, may God grant them wisdom to listen well and see the needs of the most vulnerable. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who long to see and hear God, but struggle with doubt, may they be given faith and strength to persevere. Let us pray to the Lord. For those in this faith community who use their gifts as catechists, may the Lord continue to nurture them with faith and love. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who have died, may they rest in the eternal glory of God's presence. Let us pray to the Lord. For Raymond and Ursula Fleming, and for Olga Francis and Isaac, who we remember in this Mass, let us pray to the Lord. For our personal intentions that we hold in the silence of our hearts. Let us
Amen. Thank you. morning.